Happy, happy Friday here. Thank you for joining us today.
We are glad you're with us. It's Girls' Day.
It is Girls' Day.
The boys, we ran the boys off. We said, y'all go do your thing. We'll see you later.
We've got all kinds of nice, cool things to talk about today. So, hey, but I do want to tell you, I'm excited about the weekend. Uh-huh. My brother's coming up from Tulsa and bringing a dog that they found. It's a husky.
Kelly's been wanting a dog. You've talked about this, right? She's wanted a dog, but you needed the fence fixed.
In place before I could get the dog.
Before she could get the dog.
That's right.
Until this really pretty dog showed up, and now suddenly the fence.
Well, this is what I texted. Yeah, it's like, I was telling you, it's like, I've been waiting for a dog. I wanted to get a dog. And so, you know, Dave was like, the fence has got to be fixed. It's a big job. And so he never got it done. So this dog comes along. My brother says, do you want this dog? I said, I want this dog. I love this dog. And I wrote to Dave, I kind of want him. Really, I mean, I want him. So so now the fence is getting fixed. And
did you send up a picture of the dog to show?
I didn't today. So I'm going to tell you about it on Monday.
Okay.
But we do have a couple of things to work out.
Yeah, I don't think it's a done deal.
Let's everybody pray about this.
It's a very handsome dog, I'll tell you.
It is a handsome dog. Yeah. But another dog found us a couple of weeks ago that's a stray.
See?
And he's a cutie. He's a real cutie, but he chases cars and he chases motorcycles.
And he chases the lawnmower.
And he won't let them. He bites the tires. So we've got to train him. We don't know how the two are going to get along. Honestly, I don't know what to do.
But you don't have to mow now, so the dog's doing you a huge favor. Dave's like, I like that dog.
Well, no,
this
he's
dog
like,
keeps
the
me
thing
from
that
mowing
he doesn't
lawn.
Like is that that he chases motorcycles because Dave's a motorcycle rider. And honestly, you know, you don't want a dog running out. And I don't know if he can be broke of it. I don't know why somebody dumped him off. He's a cutie. I don't know.
No chip.
And the shelters that we found so far were full. So if anybody has an idea, maybe I'll post him. He is a cute dog. He's so thankful. I'll feed him. And he'll go to the bowl, and then he'll come back at me like, thanks so much.
I love you.
I'm like, go eat.
And who would not want to land at your house?
Oh, well, what can you do?
And be loved
you have
on
to
and
take,
fed.
Absolutely.
I mean, I can't blame the dog at all, you
He's
know?
A sweetheart. He is real.
What do you call him? Buddy?
Buddy. Well, you know, it's a, hey, buddy. So it just stuck, and we didn't know if he was going to stay. So, yeah, he's Buddy right now.
Okay, so do you have a name for the maybe
yes.
dog?
Yes. My niece is 14. She's coming up. We're going to spend the day. We're going to go to the fair.
Uh-huh.
And she has named him Blue. And I said, good enough for me. I will go ahead, and we will follow through with Blue. That
dog
he's got
has
the bluest eyes.
He does have, and, like, Paul Newman blue eyes,
yeah,
this dog.
So.
But if the dog has a name, you're doomed.
Well, I know.
He's staying.
I know, and my niece wants me to have him because then she can come up and see him. But, like I say, it's not a done deal, but I am very excited, and the fence will be finished, so if this dog doesn't work out, then we'll find one that does.
The fence happened. Isn't it funny how
it
that
is.
Just
and
happened?
And I will say, he's worked 3 days on it. We've got a big piece of property in the back, so it was a job, not to mention all the poison ivy. So he's really working hard.
We'll update you on that one on Monday.
Okay,
we have a very fun show today. Dr. Emily Sutherland has a new incidental for us, and...
That's right, and we've got an update on local music.
Which I love, but before we get to it, we're going to show you what's on the radar.
That's right.
Okay. Here is something for Style Friday, or should I say Black Friday?
Mm.
Y'all are like, Joy, what do you mean Black Friday? What I mean by that is an apparent trend in black houses.
Oh.
Like painting your house black. Like this one. A recent article in Curbed says that Pinterest pins and saves for black and charcoal colored houses have grown 774% since 2014.
Wow.
What do you think about that?
You know, Jeremy's done some projects like that I wouldn't have picked the color, and it looks fantastic.
Well, the Pinterest hits spiked in March of this year,
mm-hmm.
okay? Sherwin-Williams Tricorn Black, which is a deep ebony color, is the 12th most popular color of the year.
That's crazy.
According to the article, last year was the 33rd, so it went from 33 to 12. The dark paint is number 6 in Canada. Our neighbors to the north really love it. Some lumber suppliers are selling pre-charred lumber to builders. Yeah, at premium prices too. And now in northern climates, these dark exteriors can kind of help keep the house a little bit warm.
Right.
But black homes are popping up
everywhere.
As far south as Texas, everywhere. Some designers say the hunger for all things artisanal and original are to thank for this dramatic dark house trend. What do you think? Is it too dramatic?
You know, it depends.
I think it looks really pretty.
The picture that you showed with the white, it had a lot of white on it. It had a dark roof, and you could see the color on the top. But I like that better than the all dark and then the orange paint around the windows. To me, I'm like, man, is that Halloween-y or what?
That Halloween-y.
It's Halloween-y.
It looks like an art museum thing or something at that point. Yeah. It doesn't really look like a home, but the darker the charcoal is kind of, it's interesting looking, but you run a risk. You know, they say you run a risk of maybe reselling because people are going to be like, right. What were they thinking?
Yeah, well, those are folks that maybe have built that home and they're going to stay there for a while. I think it does blend in with the landscape. I mean, I think it's rich. It's really rich.
It makes the green trees really stand out. So anyway, if you know, it's not just your imagination. People are painting
I appreciate
their homes solid black.
I wouldn't choose it, but I appreciate what it is, I think. Yeah.
I thought that was interesting.
Yeah, it
is. Got another one for you. This is crazy, okay? There is a vending machine at the San Francisco airport that's making all sorts of news for what it's selling.
Uh-oh.
We've seen crazy vending machines before. You ready for this? It's so unusual.
I don't know.
Puffer vests.
What?
Puffer vests and coats. Yeah, vests. It's a Uniqlo branded vending machine. Uniqlo, of course, the clothing maker, the store. They're all over New York City. They spit out these packable vests. That's what they look like. $50 a pop.
Oh, wow.
And a vending machine. Okay, the machine sells about $10,000 worth of these vests every month out of one vending machine.
That's crazy.
That's about 200 vests. This makes it one of the most profitable vending machines in the San Francisco airport. Who would have thunk it?
I wouldn't have.
But now think about it a second. These types of vests are apparently the unofficial uniform of all those venture capital investors who visit the Bay Area, to do all their wheeling and dealing. And they want to look all hip and they want to keep warm. And the summer temperatures can hover in the 50s and 60s. So if you think about it, Uniqlo might have said, you know, we got all these vests.
Well, you know, maybe
we're a hot brand. Let's just put them in a machine, see what happens.
That is a great idea. You know, maybe people come there, they don't realize how cool it's going to be. Maybe they didn't pack the right things.
That's what they're banking on.
Yeah, and it's like, oh, I could use a little extra. And just having this part of your body warm
makes all the difference.
All the difference. You don't even need the sleeves.
Isn't that crazy?
It is so crazy. Let's think of something really cool.
To put in a vending machine. That's what I was thinking.
What have we not thought of?
I don't know. I mean, I've seen vending machines where you can get, you know, we were talking about cupcake vending machines earlier. Yeah. And people have been doing that for a while. Yeah. But, you know, seafood and pizza vending machines and the salad, the fresh salad, you know, and farmer's fridge salad that the farmer's market fills it up every day. And then these homemade salads come out. I wish we had one of those here, but a Uniqlo vest.
Well, you know, I think it's very useful. I think people are really getting a lot of good out of that.
I guess $50 a pop, it'll keep you warm.
And they can keep it, and it also doesn't weigh a lot, so if you got to take it home, you're not going to have to pay extra. Yep.
Squish it up. All right. Coming up next, Dr. Emily from Nixa Dental has all of the answers in this week's Incidental. Don't go away. Ozarks Live is just getting started.